Instead of worrying about what the Congress should have done when they were in power with sedition, you now have the biggest majority of all time. You'd finish sedition. If you think sedition is wrong, end the law.
No, definitely. Parliamentary majority is one part. See, I'm one person who believes that parliamentary majority is only a part of the democracy, not full democracy. Full democracy is when you are active, media is active, when judiciary is active. These are the balancing, non-elected balancing institutions. Together we constitute what we call as democracy. Our constitution has then we saw that democracy where elected parliament will do its job. We are doing. You have questions, go either to the people back, which you cannot go in Tamil Nadu also, where you were a ruling party earlier. You now have 25 seats. You can't go back to people. And
Spend the last few minutes of this very engaging conversation talking about the weakness of the opposition.
Why are we pointing only at the opposition?
For 45 minutes, you've spoken about what's wrong with the government. 7 minutes, we can spend talking about what's wrong with the opposition.
More importantly, sir, nowadays, they have found internal democracy, 23 of them. In fact, he should tell us more about that.
No, so let's spend a moment, addressing the concern that the reason that the government is not fully held to account is because the Congress party as the principal opposition is led or not led by a man who's so confused that he simply doesn't know whether he wants to fight or not. And that is your misfortune that you now have to answer this question because you have a man who is kind of a leader but not quite, who's simply not cut out to the task of taking on Ram Madhav, Narendra Modi and Amit Shah.
Look, I'm engaged in fighting a state election. My party's engaged in 5 elections. I'm not going to sit here in a media conclave and start dissecting internal issues of the party that some of us are discussing within the party. When the time comes, we'll look at it. Right now, we have to absolutely stand up for what we believe in 5 states, and that's what we're doing. So this was not the theme that was given to me, and I'm not here to discuss
Only
it's not that I don't have views. I have views, but this is not the time or the place for me to express it.
Only reason I asked was, one of your 23 leaders who are working for internal democracy has praised Modi ji that he has connected the nation to its roots. I thought it's not internal, he's talking about the whole country.
No. I've spoken to him, and he said it was done in a particular context in which he was talking about his own roots to a village audience, and he was saying the Prime Minister also values his roots. Why, we all value our roots, I hope. And I think that's all that he was praising.
But
I'm
you're
very
ducking and dodging, you know. It's like, you know, you're getting a bouncer, and instead of being the cricket fan, that you are taking the bouncer and whacking it across.
Yeah, but as you know, that yesterday, Shardul Thakur took on the bouncer. He was caught on the boundary. I'd much rather duck for the moment, let the bouncer go safely over my head into Rahul Kanwal's, Ram Madhav's gloves, and we'll pick it up in a few weeks when this particular contest is behind us. In the middle of an election campaign is not the time to critique one's own
but
party.
Let's deal with
you
Kerala.
Guys are doing it enough, and he's doing it enough.
No, but let's deal with Kerala, where you come from. All opinion polls and anecdotal conversations at this time suggest that the cycle of LDF to UDF may this time change, that because of the internal weaknesses of the Congress, its inability to put up a strong fight, that Pinari Vijayan could come back to power, which, apart from everything they've done, it would be down to your weaknesses as a party and as an opposition.
Look, let me say that every election, when you say may, the cycle may end, yes. In every election, the result is unknown until the votes are counted. Let me say also that the polls, I've seen the same polls as you, and most of them, I think the most recent poll I've seen was the very end of January, early February, was when the interviews were conducted. As the British Prime Minister of the day, Harold Wilson, famously said, a week is a long time in politics. So since this poll, there have been, at least the last poll I've seen, there have been at least 4 weeks. There are 4 weeks more before the votes are cast. A lot of things can change. So even if the polls may have been an accurate picture of sentiment at that time, we have the time in the course of an energetic campaign in the next few weeks to turn that around. There have been many deficiencies in the state government, including serious issues of corruption, as well as the fact that they are hobbled, as are our friends in the BJP, by a backward-looking ideology. We need to offer an alternative, positive vision for the state, which we have and we're going to be doing. And we're going to have to persuade voters over the next few weeks that their state will be in safer hands if they come to endorse the vision of the UDF rather than that of
the
LDF.
Are you concerned, Ram Madhav ji, since Shashi Tharoor is dunking all questions on the opposition and
I've just answered this one.
To some extent, he's saying he'll come back later once we know what's happening. But are you concerned about growing agrarian opposition in states like Punjab, Haryana, Western UP? there is now a ferment amongst these farmers who are coming out on the streets, and despite 100 days having passed, your government still hasn't been able to find a solution, because you've taken a point of view, the farmers are opposing your point of view, and you're not being, because you're so firm in what you're doing, you're not being able to find a way around to maneuver this opposition from the ground.
No, farmers' agitation is certainly an important issue on a priority agenda for our government. We have held 11 rounds of talks. There are issues because the stand that the farmers are taking, rather I would say farmer leaders who are agitating, are taking, is unviable for any government to handle. If today we are not there, somebody else is there. Even then, it is very difficult to handle. To say that, you know, first of all, you withdraw all the acts, then only we will talk. Then what is left there left for one to talk? These laws are most wanted, most requested demands of the very farm organizations. Many farm organizations are today with those laws. Some are not with them, they are agitating. But I come to a very important issue, not in any condescending way or not in any charitable manner. But if this whole internal democracy debate in Congress leads to revival of Congress, India will be greatly benefited for one important reason.
You seem very worried about the Congress bouncing back. You want them to bounce back.
No. See, today where our biggest strength, third biggest strength is their leader. What can we do? So if something...
Who is their leader? If there was an answer to that question, life would be much easier.
You were asking about the farmers' agitation. What about the lack of consultation that led to that agitation?
11 rounds, sir. 11 rounds. I don't know. I mean, any other government would have sat through 11 rounds of negotiations, yet has patience to engage with them further. We are ready.